Yo, important question. How much time a day are you spending outside? Because the average American spends 90% of their time inside, 5% of their time driving, and maybe 5% of their time outside. An hour a day. Are you getting enough sunshine? Are you getting enough walking? Are you getting enough movement? Probably not. Society is cooked for a lot of reasons, and one of those reasons is that people are not spending enough time in natural environments, causing depression, obesity, breathing problems, so much wrong. In this video, I'm going to show you some ideas for how to live an outdoor lifestyle while also sharing with you my story of how I've prioritized health and living outside in my entire adult life with different
Yo, what's
ideas for a
this?
career, hustles,
Very
side hustles,
exciting.
places to live, and more. So let's dive in.
Exciting.
Welcome and fam, much love, Trav here. If you don't
Okay.
know me, I'm an adventurer and entrepreneur living out here on the island of Oahu. And most of the clips in this video are things I'm getting paid to do, actually. So we'll get into that. But I want to share this idea with you guys that
Good morning.
it's not just for rich people, it's not for trust fund people, it's actually the opposite,
Stay
right? It's
blessed and
maybe a
blessed
financial sacrifice
day and
to live a
age
life
and every
outside,
day.
but for those of us doing
Let's
it,
fucking
we like the
go.
trade that we're getting. It means
You'd
perhaps
rather have
living
more
cheaply in
fun.
some ways. It means changing our focus.
Let's
It
go.
means being a rebellious person who turns down traditional status markers of trying to get a big house or a fancy car or a gold watch, and instead saying, "Hey, I care about how I live my life. I care about how I live my time.
I found it
I care
meditating
about
a
how I spend my
lot.
time. I want it
That's
to be
why.
quality. I want it to be
Where
around
is it going
people.
for?
I want to
That's
live a
so
healthy
messed
life
up.
and it to be outside, and I see those things as being
So much
one
work.
and the same." So let's get into it. Now, when I was a beginner at this, and by the way, I grew up in the city of
Sweet.
Seattle
Haha.
in the United
So
States.
beautiful.
It gets just about the least sunlight you can get. It's also about as far north as you can get. Absolutely terrible weather. Didn't spend a lot of time outside growing up. I did in the winter, or sorry, I did in the summer, but in the winters, we wouldn't even see the sun for months at a time possible. I'm talking not even see the sun for months at a time because it's clouds sitting over the city. Sunrise at 9, I'm already at school. Sunset at 4, I'm just getting back from school, right? I didn't leave the city till 24 and started to travel and realized how much better I felt, how my sleep was regulated, how life made sense. Come back to the city, I just couldn't do it. So my first flight from the city and what I did financially, working online. Now, working online it's good. It lets you move. It can allow you to spend a lot of time outside, but you
So
need to be
pretty.
efficient with it. So I've done a lot of things for working online in my life,
So dope.
making content like this,
Yo.
making content in other genres, other niches, selling services, making ads, doing the whole online business thing. I've done that. And it's good. It's more competitive now than it's ever been. But there's also maybe more opportunity now than there's ever been. And I've shifted, I've went another direction to trying to focus on spending my time outside by working outside. Because one of the problems with making your money
That's
online
exciting.
is generally a pretty solitary process. It's a solitary thing. You may spend time talking to people online, but it's a Monday afternoon and you want to go outside. What are you going to do? Now, you can. I mean, I moved down to Humboldt County. I didn't have a car, just had a bicycle. I'm biking the California coast. I'm hiking up the Redwoods, right? But I'm spending a lot of time alone. And after a while, I was drawn towards working outside. And the thing about working outside is, I'm not like I want the good life, right? And that's not just spending time outside, being healthy, but also with like-minded people, with other people. So, I've worked in a number of industries outside. The first one is agriculture. I've done shepherding. You see some clips with sheep in this video. I've done growing vegetables. I've done planting fruit trees, all kinds of stuff. Worm composting. I got my feet dirty and my hands wet in the soil, right? I've done a lot of things. I worked farmers markets on Saturdays. I started a little plant nursery. I did many things. And that was a wonderful way to live. There's a beautiful book called, and by the way, I don't have that much footage on the farming. This was 7, 6, 5, 4 years ago. And I just don't have the footage. And by the way, this is a different kind of video. If you like it, make sure to leave a comment. I don't really know how it's going to do or how I want it to do because it's different and it's I'm in my routine. But I have all these clips and I'm just going to share them with you and talk to you about how you can get outside, live a life outside, and try to fix one of the serious problems with society in today's age is people aren't living like the animals that they should. We're animals, yo. We're meant to bathe in the ocean. We're meant to bathe in springs and streams. Hunt for our food, whatever it is. But I'm continuing on with the story. The working out outside, working on a farm, there's a very beautiful book called Letters to Young Farmers. And it talks about, or there's a quote in there about how the pay of being a farmer is you're getting paid in sunrises, you're getting paid in sunsets, you're getting paid for that morning dew, you're getting paid for seeing the trembling birth of a baby lamb or a baby calf. And that is a wonderful, beautiful thing and perk of living outside, where my time on the farm, am I making a lot of money? No, I'm not making a lot of money, but I was surviving and I'm growing rich on experience and skills. If I need to grow something, I can. If I need to butcher something, I can do that too. So that's one of the first things of working outside, but it's evolved. You know, I took a break and focused on cryptocurrency, and the idea again here in trading and various trading, the idea here is you make a lot of money and you can spend your time outside. But I ran into the same problems that I did when I was running online business earlier in my 20s, is who's really there to hang out on a Tuesday afternoon, right? Or Tuesday morning, right? People are at work. So I wanted to get back to work. And as far as trading goes or any kind of online business, I'm not a fan of spending more than max 1 to 2 hours a day on it. And it is possible with an online business to do well working 1 to 2 hours online. It's actually possible. You just got to understand leverage and strategy. And you'll never be the best in the industry doing that. But the goal is not to be the best in the industry. The goal is to feed this online lifestyle where you can spend your time outside, right? So I have to note, though, that I also moved to Hawaii. And one of the reasons people always ask me why I did it, and a lot of the reason I did it, is so that I can spend more time outside. I was in California, I was in Humboldt, I was growing food, I was working on the farms, and an issue that I was having is that in the winter time, everybody went indoors, and the farm shut down, and there wasn't so much to do. So it made sense. Moved to Hawaii, where there's a 365-day growing season. There's something going on outside all day, every day, all year. And I'm super happy I made that move. But I'm not telling you to move to Hawaii. You don't necessarily need to do that. There's Southern California. There's Florida. You could be seasonal. You could be in a van. You could be going and camping in the national parks. These are things that I could see myself doing in another lifetime, or if things had gone a little bit different, or maybe things even in my future could go a little bit different. But there's a lot of ways to live it, and I'm not telling you that you need to move to Hawaii. That's something I'm trying to avoid. I'm showing these clips that are on Hawaii mostly, but you could move to Colorado. You could do this in Colorado. You could climb mountains. You could be a river raft guide. So anyways, back to my story. A lot of these, you don't know which of these I'm getting paid for or not, because I took this idea of being outside and I launched a private hiking adventure service. So there's driving involved. There's some driving involved, but I get paid to go hiking. I get paid to go cliff jumping. I get paid to often explore new spots because people ask me to take them to places that I've never even been to, and it's an opportunity for me to spend a lot of time outside. And my goal is to spend at least 50% of my time outside, which means most of the waking hours outside, because I'm in bed 9 to 10 hours a day, Or I could even just sleep outside. I don't really have a problem with that. That was one of the camp spots when I was on Kauai for the backpacking trip. I mean, some of this is for fun. Most of what I'm showing you is on the job. Another thing that I'm doing is working on a boat, all the boat clips, doing marine wildlife tours. I broke into this, feel pretty lucky that they hired me, but you know, I grew up swimming. I've spent a lot of time swimming. Spent a lot of time outside, worked on my teamwork, and got my own hiking, my own tour business going. So it was kind of inevitable one of these companies would hire me. And now just have that thrown in the mix where some days I'm out in the ocean getting paid, some days I'm out in the mountains getting paid. A lot of the time I'm even on the beach getting paid to take a nap in the midday. So again, there's this idea that, oh, it's not for me, it's for, you know, trust fund or rich. No, it's you guys have it backwards. A lot of the time there's a financial sacrifice that's taking place. Right? And you think, oh, I couldn't do it because there's just a lot of excuses. Now, I'm not going to tell you it's for everyone, but I really believe that anyone who wants to do this could do this in some variation, in some version. Can you spend more time outside? Yes. Or at least orient yourself to make it a goal? Yes. And it wasn't even a goal for me until my 20s. It's taken me a while to get here, but I'm here. I just want to share that possibility and that energy with you. Now, part of it as well is one of the reasons why people think, oh, I can't do it, is because there's not enough money in these outdoor jobs and outdoor experiences. Mm-hmm. First of all, you'd be surprised, especially with the hiking tour business. I'm surprised how much money I can make, how high my rate can be. And depending on the situation, if you own your own tour company or you own your own tour outfit, you own your own gear, you can do pretty well doing these things and getting paid to be outside. Now, the other flip side of that is spending less money, right? Reducing your wants. Me, I want to eat good food, I want to sleep good, I want to be around friends, and I want to be outside. That's about it. I don't need much more than that, right? So what you're not going to see me doing in this video is going out drinking, going out to nice restaurants, spending money. I don't need that. I'm cooking at home. I'm having friends over. We're grilling up a rabbit on the grill. I'm going to go hunting. You go hunting and actually get paid to be outside. Hunting is a way where you come back with meat. So that's why you see me working with the bow there. I'm getting ready to go up in the mountains here and hunt some goats. Also on the docket for 2025. Potentially is getting into spearfishing out here. I like the idea of I could just walk outside and go snag me some dinner and come back. But yeah, you see me in my videos, some people are like, why should I take advice from someone who's got a cheap car? Bro, you should take advice from me on how to buy a car for $1,100 that works. People buy lemons, get wrecked. People buy new cars and get stuck on some interest payment, paying car payment for 2 years, really eating into their finances, their ability. Where me, I got my Toyota Corolla for $1,100 a year and a half ago, and it's needed almost no work. And I just, I'm living cheap, you know. I spend a lot on food, and I make sure I live in a nice place that's walkable. And I just don't spend on. My dates are generally cheap, right? Because I take people to the beach, I'll take girls hiking, right? And then I'm getting paid for all these activities that I would want to do anyways. It's a really low cost of living, and to an extent, it's achievable by anyone. So if you're listening to this and you're watching and you're like, all right, well, how do I start? What do I do? My suggestion, the first thing is just asking the question and orienting yourself. But I shared with you a number of possibilities. You can work online and be very efficient. You can work in agriculture. You can work in outdoor adventure tourism. You can work farmers markets. You can do some combination of all of those things. And there's more. You could be like a camp counselor, doing outdoor sports camps, You know, you'd be like a. Share down below. What are some other jobs? Outdoor photography. Photography is a good one where you could spend a lot of time outside, actually. Doing outdoor photography, adventure photography, tourism photography, and stuff like that. I mean, even being a construction worker, I don't think is that bad, and can pay well. But the goal is just to get outside, though, but not necessarily around concrete, around natural places. So another thing is thinking about where the best place for you to live. And it doesn't necessarily mean, again, moving to Hawaii or Colorado. But it might mean moving to a place that's more walkable, a place that is closer to a park or something. I mean, I always value just being able to walk outside, and I'm outside, I'm on the first floor. Being able to walk to the beach, walk to the ocean, walk to the lake, just go swim, walk back, have days of my day off, maybe I never get in the car, spend a lot of the day outside. So that's something you could think about, is changing where you live. And again, it doesn't necessarily mean moving to a whole new state. It might just mean changing where you live. But wherever you rent, think about not like, is this the biggest space, but is this a location that's going to give me a lot of outdoor walkability, also where I can meet people potentially. And then thinking about your career. Now, it's not that easy necessarily to break into a lot of these outdoor industries, which are also, a lot of the time, it's a young man's game, because if you're a raft guide, yo, if you're a shark diving instructor, if you're a scuba master, right, it's better to start on these things early. But I want you to understand that it's never too late to start on any of these things. And if you need inspiration to get fit, get in shape, look no further. Now, barring all that, you can just look at Friday, Saturday, Sunday and say, how am I going to spend this time to go outside? I'm going to go camping. I'm going to go hiking. I'm going to go climbing. I'm going to go down the coast. I'm going to do something and spend it outside. Or I'm going to plan my vacation instead of just thinking, okay, I'm going to go explore some new city. No, I'm going to go on a backpacking trip. I'm going to go on a through hiking trip. I'm going to go to a place where I can spend the whole time outside, right? I had a week like that this summer, again, where I was outside. I was either outside or in the car. We were camping. I slept outside, tents open to the ocean. My feet are dangling out. Nice temperature in the summer. Just got a silk sheet over my body. I'm chilling. I'm outside. Or in the car 24 hours a day. I could do something like that. So, if you're new to me, welcome aboard. Again, I have no idea how this video is going to do. It's a totally different format and concept. It might do awesome, and if you want to see it do awesome, comment down below anything that boosts the algorithm. You think that I'm right? You think that I'm winning? I think I'm winning. I do think I'm winning. And at the end of the day, though, it doesn't necessarily have to be a sacrifice. I mean, I like what I'm giving up. I like what I'm getting. But there's worlds where you can do well financially also at the same time. How? Because some of these industries can pay well, and also your side hustle can do well too. And I don't have kids yet, but it's possible to raise kids this way too. There's some really cool stories of doing it. And I mean, honestly, I think about having kids, and I would love to teach them, yo, here's, we're going to hike up in the mountains today. I'm going to show you how to hunt a goat and skin a goat, right? Or we're going to go out into the ocean today. I'm going to show you how to spearfish dinner. These are some practical skills. Chop wood, right? Actual skills that will exist also that aren't going to get replaced by AI. You know, these might not be the most high-paying jobs, but these are jobs that are going to continue to exist. These outdoor jobs, being a guide, or growing food, right? A lot of the tech jobs, the online jobs, getting replaced by AI, but someone needs to actually be there to shake someone's hand, talk to them, and take them on an adventure, or to pull the carrots from the ground. I mean, again, machines can do that part, but yo, so man, it's there's just another way to live, and it makes me sad to see people who aren't tapping into this. And I wake up every morning, really tap dance to work, I think, in the morning. Like, my God, my life is so good. I'm so grateful. So amazing. I can't even believe life is so good. But also very grateful, but afraid of, oh man, like if I had to go back to a city, if everything went wrong, what would I do? But thank God I don't have to. I'm where I am now, and I'm doing everything I can to stay here and make it even better if I need to, but I'm happy where I am. So thanks to everybody for tapping in. Appreciate y'all. Much love, and look forward to seeing what you have to say in the comments. Peace.